When I marched in the civil rights movement, I did not march with a 12-point program. I marched with tens of thousands of others to change attitudes. And we changed attitudes.
He lied to voters, according to the New York Times, quoting aides of Biden's, about having marched in the civil rights movement.
I got involved in the civil rights movement.
I got involved in desegregated movie theaters. They organized voter registration drives.
From the time I got involved as a high school kid in the civil rights movement.
But I was a kid involved in the civil rights movement, desegregating restaurants and movie theaters in my state.
From the time I got involved as a kid in the civil rights movement.
Sit-ins and desegregating restaurants.
And I got involved in the civil rights movement just as a kid.
And that's why I got so deeply involved in my community with the civil rights movement.
When I sat in black churches in the east side of Wilmington getting ready to, and by the way, next to two Jewish rabbis, getting ready to go out and desegregate movie theaters in Delaware.
I came out of the civil rights movement.
I start off in the black churches and we'd go from there to desegregate movie theaters.
For real, I got involved in the civil rights movement.
From the time I've been 18 years old, I've been involved in causes from the civil rights movement.
Got involved in the civil rights movement and desegregating restaurants, that kind of thing.
Coming out of the civil rights movement and being involved in the Jewish community as a kid in the civil rights movement.
I got involved in the civil rights movement.
Getting ready to go out and desegregate restaurants and movie theaters.
That's what got me involved in civil rights as a kid.
I got very engaged, in my case, the civil rights movement.
Quote, more than once, advisors had gently reminded Mr. Biden of the problem with this formulation. He had not actually marched during the civil rights movement. And more than once, Mr. Biden assured them that he understood and kept telling the story anyway. That is really, really weird.
And I wonder what you would like to say about your son and whether any of his troubles have caused conflicts for you or for the United States.
No, there's not a single thing that I've observed at all from that would affect me or the United States relative to my son Hunter.
What's your role as vice president in charge of policy in Ukraine, your son's job in Ukraine? How is that not a conflict of interest?
It's not a conflict of interest. There's been no indication of any conflict of interest from Ukraine or anywhere else.
His son, as soon as he became vice president, I hear they paid him $183,000 a month.
My son has not made money in terms of this thing about, what are you talking about, China.
You wrote the crime bill.
Where we come from, that's called Tommy Come Lately.
There are other people here. Put hundreds of thousands of young black and Latino men in prison.
Okay. Let me say something.
Thank you.
There's something going on here. I have worked for racial justice completely, and that is an absolute unfair statement.
All I know is
Tommy Come Lately.
And the strategy calls for you to significantly increased penalties, as Senator Thurman and I wrote the bill, and now is required in federal law. They warned us when Thurman and Biden went out there and insisted on flat time sentencing. They warned us it was going to increase prison crowding. It did. They were right. Well, I want to tell you all, and it's the right thing to do, in my view. He and I wrote the law.